Greetings, everyone, and welcome to the next episode of Project... No, not Project Ozone. That was a good start, wasn't it? Should we start again? Greetings, everyone, and welcome to the next episode of Infinity. Yes, yes, he gets it right. Bless him. He's an old man. I am indeed an old man. So, what's happening? Well, I have to admit, I've realised, let me just move my microphone back, I've realised that I'm unhappy. I'm very unhappy with everything. It just doesn't seem to go very well. So, I mean, I've laid out this little path here. I want to try and tie everything together. As you can see there's something occurring. And I get to unify this area. It just seems all very nondescript. I've got this kind of look here, another look there, another look over here. While I'm actually looking at this, I've been doing a little test. You know, I've been having problems with the hummus turning to sand. Well, it doesn't matter even if you close it in and you encage it. Still does it. But the plus side, dirt doesn't. Hummus, which is more expensive, does. So, I think the plan is that we're going to stay with dirt. So I've re-dirted, as you can see here. I tried with this very ghetto-style roof thing. But it's not working. So I've been replacing everything with normal sand. Had a sausage roll. Time for a slurp of Coca-Cola. It's the real thing, apparently. Oh, yes. So it seems that the cheaper the ground, the better. Okay. Well, I've spent some time redoing all these, but that's by the by. I need to remove these test roofs. It's all... This is what made me a little bit annoyed with myself. Excuse me. Swinging my mouse around. But, yeah, it just all didn't tie in, and it's annoying me. So I started looking at some block types, how I want this to look. Quite like the trodden dirt's quite nice. It's very, not sure if it's nice here or whether it's lighting level. That should be maximum. Done. We're gonna slow everything down there. Well, not maximum, because that looks quite horrible. Let's put that at this. So let's leave it like that. So, thinking about doing some pathways of some description to tie everything together. But then I thought, it's the real thing. It's getting me every time. But then I thought, this tree farm is in the way. This is an old legacy build. Off, let me switch that on. Then I've got this nonsense down here, and the bees, let's not speak of the bees. These are all up here, and I was thinking of walling this off in some way and actually making this into a more of an organized farm rather than this nonsense. As I always say, you know, form follows function, but unfortunately, function is ugly at the moment, so I'm having a bit of a dichotomy with that. So it's off now. Now I can see the wood for the trees, so to speak. So I may move this out of the way. I've also got up here the power plant, never actually been switched on yet, so I don't really want it here. So what I'm thinking of doing with that is putting that out at sea, somewhere out here, maybe building a platform that will have the power station on it, and then we'll condemn this one. But I do need lots of jellied cryothium, some ender liquids. That. But it's just that, as you can see, like, I do like these, but they're a little bit... They don't blend in with the land very much. It's only when I did this down here, this boardwalk simple little boardwalk thing. Still not finished. Story of this entire season. And that's what's kind of getting my gears all in a grind, to be honest. So I need to start unifying things. So what I'm going to do, as you can see, I've got a nice little river winding down here. All very lovely, you know, all windy, lovely thing that starts over this way. Starts for no valid reason, but it starts. So thinking of maybe expanding this. I mean, then you've got the Ender Portal that's just stuck in the middle of nowhere. Doesn't seem to have any right place. So I need to do something here. Now, I have been talking of moving. I don't really want to move. I want to try... The initial reason why I wanted to move, let's back this truck up, is I wanted to move because of the hummus problem we have here. But as I found out, the hummus problem is going to be a problem wherever I go. Don't think it's anything to do with the temperature. I could be wrong. I've been known to be wrong in the past, but just so messy and unorganized, and yeah. And then I've got inside here. I'm not happy with this door. This door just doesn't seem to work. I like the idea of the garage door, but unfortunately the options that you've got are not very good, and they've got this rather poop texture on it that doesn't fit with anything. I do like this look. Or this look here, the way it fits in. And I've now moved all this into a nice area. Still yet to finish this. Should actually finish things before I start recording, but I just like to show you that, you know, not everything is done off camera. Some things are still work in progress. So, as you know, I moved all of this section. I extended into here. All the ME drives are now downstairs, but look, ba-bung, just a big open space of nothing. No wonder Aldous sits here staring out into the void. Well, I've also changed my render distance. Reason being, I quite like the fog. Gives it a little bit of an atmosphere. Drop the fog down to 0.2 in Optifine, something like that, and it's rather nice. As you recall, last episode, I think it was, I did show you that I'd moved everything into a separate room here, so we now have all the sag mills and the alloy smelters. Little bits of thermal expansion down there. Again, you know, it just grinds my gears because it kind of looks nice, but it's not thematic. This is not working with this. Like half-cocked ideas run together. Yeah, like a cyanide reprocessor in the middle of nowhere doing nothing. Ooh. This is not working properly, hence the big hole. Oh, you know, it sometimes makes me think, should I just start again? I mean, should I? I mean, let's have a look at the map. The map will load. There you go. We've got lots of places we could journey over to. What I do like is extreme hills. I like the different levels and things you can get from that. But I don't know. Leave a comment. Let's go on this journey together. There's quite a nice area here. Although there are some, if you look down in here, there are some rather bad chunk errors. Area. And regenerate this by deleting the file so it regens itself. Which is a possibility. I could do that. Or maybe over this side, I've gone for a wander this way. Some quite nice places. The crags, unfortunately, are a lag-tastic place, unfortunately. I did have a build once, FTB I think it was, and it was rather laggy over there. And I do believe I got a corrupt chunk once in the crags, and I had to basically fish all the items out of there slowly but surely. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. Is it too far gone? Have I put too much work into it? Have I not put enough into it? Is the question. It's getting dark again. Let's go to sleep and muse on that question. We won't be musing for long. So yeah. It's intriguing. It's definitely intriguing. So I'm going to try and develop the outside a little. And I'll definitely move this. Get one blot on the landscape out of the way. And then I'll reform these. I'll reform these and make them proper pathways rather than these little lines. I just kind of did these lines as a tracer just to see how it would look from above, how it would work. Yeah. Let me, because this is going to move obviously, so these paths aren't going to be so close together. And I'll probably build something around here because, you know, I've been into the Nether. I've done some little bits of tidy ups on the Nether portal on the other side. Eventually loads. And there we go. And here we are with Monsieur Sheep. So I've done a little bit of work on this side, just to part this area up a little bit. Quite like the contrast between the sandstone and the nether brick. Cheap. But yeah, so I definitely want to keep this area, so let's go back. Oh, no, you cannot come. And so yeah, I just need to tidy this area up. Quite sure. I'll do the path first and I'll start dropping some of these areas like I've done with this section here. And let's try and get some nice build in this area. Some nice flow. Some flow is what I need. I'm not getting any flow here whatsoever. It's just like, oh, let's plonk that there. Let's plonk that there. Let's plonk that there. Stop plonking. Time to get on with some real work. I think I've done some rather good changes, actually. Initially, I was quite miffed about the whole thing, to be honest. But I was a little bit miffed. But hey ho, look what we got now. Let me just Let me just turn my hover off. So now we have some little paths made out of trodden dirt. Nice little wood stairs as a trim around the sides. There are two different types of this. These are the dirt slabs. These are the trodden dirt. Now these actually look nicer. The only problem is with these is that when you are in hover mode, when you go over this, you begin to hover, so you automatically fly, which was a bit of a pain, even though I do like this darker texture. Sand. Okay, misty buff. But I think it works quite well. It's got a nice flow to it. You know, you can't see the ender portal down that way, and you can't see up there, and it's a nice little wander through, and you come down. Got the ender portal here. I've just trimmed this off at the moment. There's nothing going on around the back at the moment. On there, eagles. Now that goes. And then I've got another little step here, and then I've finally put some stairs up to the garden up here. So everything's starting to be accessible now, as you can see. The tree farm's gone. It's now located over there, out of the way. I've still got the sludge boiler. That still needs to go, and that complete mess needs to be sorted. But I've taken some time. Had a play around, and as you can see here, the mob spawners have gone. They are in the process of being moved down underneath. Yeah, simply because they're just too far away over here. I spend most of my time in this quadrant. Let's just hover up here, kind of in this quadrant here. So with them being over this side, they tended not to work as well, because I was very rarely over this side unless I was coming down and picking eggs and things down here. I've yet to do this, not quite sure if I'm keeping the cow and chicken farm down there yet. That's yet to be developed. That is development. So yeah, that's gone. That's gone from here. I'll show you that in a moment. It is underground. The reason I put it there is because eventually I'm going to put cursed earth in it, so it can be a natural spawner. And that'll spawn anywhere. You don't have to be within 16 blocks of the spawners, which is all well and good, but if you put it in the same chunk, it'll work even better, I think. That's what I've had in the past. Also of note, let's just shimmy on up here. Look, big eyesore of a power plant has gone. This one's even been switched off. In fact, I can take that from here. This one is now switched off. Still has a lot of fuel in it, but you know, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? I have to dismantle this yet anyway. The new one is, let's go down for the big reveal. I've moved it out to sea. Here it is. This is the big one. Put it on little stanchions and little uprisers here. I'm gonna build this out, make it look a bit more as if it's carrying weight. I know that physics are defied in Minecraft, but I still like it look to make it look, see like this here. Okay, I'm getting my words out, I'm so excited. Like this here. You can see that these pillars go all the way down on this side. So I haven't just stopped it underneath there and made it float as I could have done. I'm gonna build it up around here as well, make it a little bit thicker. Possibly do some arcing struts across here, bit like an oil rig. But I've done this. This is probably the biggest reactor I've done yet. And as you can see, there's snow on the top, which means that there's jellied cryothium inside here. Around the edges, we have enderium. Just for sure, really. I don't really need it. I could have filled it with jellied, but quite like this. It's a nice inverted rain look. So we've been a busy beaver, so slowly but surely things are coming on. I've also put down some grass and some more flowers, and I've tried to remove most of the straight edges. Straight edge here, this is where the end of pearl endstone do for me bob was. So I've built that out a touch just to make it look a little bit neater. So what's next? Well, next is going to be moving this badger into a better place, yet to be decided. I thought I'd extend somewhat and move down here to more a natural tree farm, and then put a bedrockium drum up there, so I don't really have to worry about this too much. It'll just slip within the area of the plants. I've got a little elevator there, so I can pop down to the inner workings, which is just nice and straightforward. Simple as, look at that. Conduit connector straight to the planter. Just like that. Ooh, I need to. This one? No, it's in this one, isn't it? And yeah, I need to go and get one of these. That. Backlist it. That'll stop any of these saplings going into the ender chest and disappearing off into the inter. Only problem is when this fills up, because it does fill up really quickly, when all these stacks are full, that consume stack, that might be better. But when all those are full, it tends to jam up here. So I do have to look at that every now and again. I may do some kind of redstone system here. That's yet to be decided. I'm in no great need for lots of wood. I have thousands of it. Also, neat little things around here. You won't really notice them, but I do. You know, like little pillars here. And there was a few bits of dirt on that side, so I popped in some bogs down there to make it look more robust. This was all janky, if you remember last time. So I've just popped in some spruce wood there. And in here, I still have my fishroom spores, my nether wart growing in here. It will grow in darkness, but if it's in darkness, you can't really see. So I've just popped a little redstone torch in there, just to offer a bit of low light. Darkness in there. So let's go into the main house, shall we? Fly for this. Fly me to the moon. Well, at least to the entrance anyway. Still haven't looked at the garage door yet. Might actually just change the texture, to be honest. Don't like this texture. I've expanded this into a little bedroom, because before I had my bed down there somewhere, just in a corridor. So I thought I'd make a little bedroom here. I'll eventually pimp this out. I popped in the experience obelisk in there. So in fact, let's store all my XP so I don't lose it. Nothing else has changed. Everything is still the same. I've sorted out this room here. Last time it was a bit of a mess. Still things to do here. We've still the RF room to build. I may put the RF room in there. I'm seriously considering having an entrance on the corner. So take out this, so you've got a bit of a diagonal there, just to break it up. But then my OCD will say I need a diagonal there and I need one there. But let's leave that for now. Too many problems. So what have we got down here? What's changed? Nothing much has changed down here. I pretty much kept it the same. I've been testing out these carpenter's wedge blocks as opposed to solid blocks. Kind of like them. It just gives a little bit of something, you know. And these just work away. And I pop this little factory block down here, just trying to break up the big lumps of shape that we've got. So let's pop downstairs. And here we are, down in what's going to be the kill chamber. If you remember from my last series, I had something similar to this, but I want to do just update it slightly. So I'm going to have spawners on one side and then natural spawns on the other. This is where the cursed earth is going to go. And I've just literally dug this out. The idea is I'm going to have two access doors, one either side. And those are going to go in and around and all the way around the back. This is going to go that way for a long way, I reckon. Yeah, I think so. A long way that way. Or I might just turn all these round. I don't know. It's one of those. Form follows function and all that. I've kept the style from outside. Just, you know, messed it up a little bit. Put the carpenter's blocks on the outside with some glowstone dust in them. And I found this as well. I thought I'd let you into this one. Let me just hover them. Whilst I was digging down here, there was an awful lot of noise. A lot of zomboids doing the thing. And look what I found. Let's just hop down here. Found a spawner directly underneath it. See, it's kind of fate. This is where the spawners are going to be. So I've got that little fella spinning around in his cage down there. I mean, I've had a look around. There's nothing much down here. I've cleared this out before you start yelling you missed a chest. It does go on a little bit. There's I keep getting stuck there. Right. You know, there's some stuff and things down here. More things and essence berry bushes. It is quite extensive down here. I'm gonna have to light all this up. I was now. No. Yes, it was. It was up there, wasn't it? That's the thing I keep losing. I'm getting old. Right up here. Oh, hi, spider. You actually here? Yes, you are. So let's pop back up here again. The good thing is we're getting spawns down here. Now, the magnum torch I've got up at the top is saving me from natural spawns up there, but I'm wondering if it's running out down here. I mean, we are at Y29, so shouldn't be too bad. But anyhow, I thought I'd clue you in on this before I blocked it all off, which I shall do that right now. If I just stick a quarry block there, and then there, and then I'll show you how to do this. I'm not quite sure if I've shown you this. You can add glowstone dust to carpenter's blocks. If you hold down shift and then right click, you see that change in light then? That means that this is now lit. I don't need torches. Take those off. And then what you can do is you can select a block. I'm using blocks of ruby because they're nice and blood red. And right click, and then poof, just looks like a block. But it's actually emitting light. How cool is that? It's a cool, cool thing. So then. It. I think that's as far as we've got. I'm going to put some of the factory blocks down here, make it look a bit grimy and industrial. The problem I had with it... the problem I had with it is the coffee. Let me take another swigger. This good stuff. Fine Colombian blend. The problem with this is it just didn't fit in with the very stony kind of this kind of look. This and wood didn't really fit with this, so that's another reason why I wanted to move it out of sight, so it didn't become like an ugly blot on the landscape. I've still got the drawbridges in there. Now this is going to be one of the spawners. I'm going to put the blaze spawner back in here, so I'll also chisel out up there and put the glowstone droppers in there, so I can switch lights on if I need to. But I've yet to dig out all behind here and maybe make another few of these down here for extra droppages. And yeah, and then so I think in the next episode we will get on with some cursed earth. If you watched me do that in Project Ozone, you know I am an absolute ninja at it, which is a total lie. I think I failed 3 or 4 times last time. So, let's see what happens. Anyway, I shall love you and leave you. I shall see you on the flip side. And as always, much love. Much love.